Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri. I thought you'd like a look at this very mean 1973 Dodge Dart. And this essentially is like a street legal drag car, so it's been modified quite a bit. We'll check it out here. You can see it has a nicely painted front bumper, and that's actually a fiberglass bumper. You know, they just wanted to get a little weight off the front end for better weight transfer. Always a good idea. And of course it's all business under the hood here. They actually started, we'll check the specs, but I believe they started with a 383 and put a 440 crank in there and bored it 40 over and then proceeded to fill it with the best parts they could. You can see it's nicely dressed out as well. Nice chrome air cleaner up top here and some Mopar Performance valve covers. Of course you have a big Holley 4 barrel up top. And that's sitting on a nice high-rise intake. You can see it also has port-injected nitrous. That's a 250 horse nitrous setup on there. But everything's just really nicely done. You can see even the throttle return springs and bracketry. Everything's just done the way it should be. Very impressive. Of course, it has a nice set of headers as well. Up front here, you have an aluminum water pump. Some nice billet pulleys, even a polished alternator. And that's one of the things that kind of strikes you about the car is that despite being a drag car, it's also just so beautifully done. I mean, it really looks like a show car. You can see how the inner fenders, the firewall, everything is just really nicely done. Very impressive. Up front here, you can see it has the billet MSD distributor. It also has an MSD coil, of course. Serious machine, and they've got the cam specs and everything there on the info sheet, so we'll take a look at that before we're done. Up front here you can see they've added an aluminum radiator. Very nice. And in addition to your standard fan here, they've added some electric fans to keep it nice and cool. Always a good idea. Just really impressive quality on this car. As you can see, it's in sort of a copper, I believe they're calling it a Sunburst Orange paint. It's nicely done. It is riding on some weld wheels. Got a little set of skinnies up front and a nice wide set out back. As you can see, it has the striping. It goes all the way down the side. The glass looks good. Got the chrome mirrors on here as well. It does have a big cowl hood, and that is fiberglass. And of course, it has hood pins. Extremely well done on the interior as well. You can see it has a couple of fiberglass racing buckets with harnesses. Has a full cage set up. And as you can see, the nitrous bottle is right between the seats. Here, we'll take a closer look. Still has the factory door panels. And it is an automatic. It's a 727 Torqueflite automatic. But as you can see, it has a B&M shifter and I believe a 3000 RPM stall converter. So it's pretty serious. Nice Mopar Performance steering wheel. It does have all custom gauges. Those look really nice. You have a shift light over here on the left. I like this painless switch panel they have here as well, so you can control your fuel pump and electric fans and everything like that. And that's a nitrous controller. I mean, whoever built this knew what they were doing, that's for certain. Just extremely well done throughout. Here, we'll continue on out back. You can see you have the 440 decaling back here. And like I said, a little fatter set of tires at the rear, of course. They're currently running slicks on it, but you could easily run some drag radials if you wanted to. It does have an 8¾-inch rear with sure grip. A nice set of drag shocks back here. Of course, when you go to the track, you have to have an electrical shutoff. That's a nice spot for it. It has the matching painted rear bumper. But like I said, what impresses me most about the car is just the overall quality. I mean, the bodywork and the paint, it's just really nice car. You can see they've tinted all the windows as well. Definitely the nicest Dodge Dart that I've ever seen. Very impressive. Okay, let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1973 Dodge Dart. Sunburst Orange. Like I said, 383 back by Torqueflite. Honestly, I don't know what the cubic inches are at this point. With the 440 crank, board 40 over. Here you can read all the details. It does have disc brakes up front. It's a great idea. But, I mean, just a beautiful car. And definitely plenty fast, I'm sure. Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you like taking a look at that one. I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have, and I'll see you later. Bye.